but these two were the first, like, they were the first kind of leaders in Smash 4, you know? Marlo had, like, a dynasty for, like, 6 months where no one could beat him. Marcelo and yourself were always right behind him, you know?
But for the past summer, I had a 7-win streak, but
yeah,
then I
no,
lost.
Yeah, no, definitely. You were definitely a titan in the game. That's why it's sort of surprising to not see you here in the top four getting taken out by Takai.
It was unfortunate, but then I wasn't really in my best play.
That just happens, you know. It's one tournament does not determine who is the best forever. It's just who's the best that day.
It's okay. There's always another time. Again, for those who want to play Smash again, EMC Battlegrounds.
Yeah.
Next week.
We have Battlegrounds next week, held by the EMC Club at University of Guam. And for those who just want to stay updated with the fighting game community, check us out on GUFGC on Facebook. That's GU space FGC. Stands for the Guam Fighting Game Community. But right now we got the grand finals of Smash 4, Marlo versus Marcelo.
Wow, they're getting straight into it. No warm-ups. All right.
So if you guys don't know the way grand finals works, the way grand finals works is the person coming from loser's bracket, aka Marlo, has to win 2 sets of 1st-to-5. Dang, Marcelo going for 2 gimps here, trying to save everyone's time and get this done quick. Oh!
Oh, covers the...
Man, Marcelo really has a lot of freedom offstage with Rob's great up B recovery.
Yeah, Rob is a very wonky character, and he has a lot of tools in his disposal. He can zone out, and he can also throw a lot of people off. He has a... What's his downside is his big hitbox.
Yeah, that's true. And his up B is also not the fastest in the world.
It can be gimped.
Yeah, it also has no hitbox too while he's flying, so he's totally free to get hit while he's flying.
Right now, Marcelo is dominating the stage.
And you know what? I love seeing Marlo's like mastery of DD's recovery. There's just so many times I feel like he shouldn't make it back that he finds the right angle and the right charge for it.
Yeah, true. It can throw off a lot of people and thinking that and underestimating the
rage.
Recovery.
Yeah. Not only just the rage, but how much you can angle it while you're flying, you know, to really get the hard to reach spots. Oh, good mix up there with the recovery. Fakes going on stage, it goes back to the ledge.
Alright, so possible gimp right here. Oh,
good use of the top to bird his double jump. Oh!
But a back throw kills, and it's not Ness for once. Alright.
Marlo, though, with 134%. Marcelo just needs one good read, and this is the game. There, he went for the read right there, and now he's getting punished for it.
Oh, that could have killed, but he got lucky.
This could kill?
No, it's not.
What does the down throw kill in this game? With Rob?
I believe that was an up.
Up throw?
It's an up throw. It kills. It really depends. Most likely it will end 160 if they have no DI.
I see. But Marcelo taking that first game pretty clean. This is surprising considering Marlo has generally been the favorite between these two. But Marcelo dominated Marlo in winner's bracket and he's dominating him right now in game one of grand finals.
Lately, Marcelo's Rob has been very on point today, so I don't expect him to flunk anytime soon.
I'm really kind of proud of Marcelo for sticking with Rob, because I remember when that Rob was pretty weak.
Yeah.
I remember when that Rob was free, and now it's here in the grand finals of one of the biggest Smash 4 tournaments we've ever had.
Oh, all right. We're just going at it right now.
And I feel like maybe, it was kind of crazy putting himself off stage. I feel like Marcelo's Mario might have been figured out by Marlo's Diddy.
It's been downloaded by me and Marlo personally.
I see.
Also Brian in some cases. Oh!
Those apparently.
Again, a tip for Smash players. If you're going to get spiked, always DI to the stage and then you can possibly check it.
Yeah, give yourself a shot at least.
Alright. Oh, we tried to go for a down air, but Marlo's getting really greedy with those. Oh!
No tech from Rob either. And that was kind of the first stage fight I've seen all set. So good of Barlow to keep that option in mind and just catch Marcelo off guard.
Marlow is getting back. Oh, then Rob comes back. Oh, those three down tilts.
This is kind of the first time where they're on last stock and even. Marlow's been playing from behind since the first game, so really interesting to see a game where it's kind of towards the end of the game and they're both close, you know?
Yeah.
Both on their last stock. No one has a clear lead. This is anyone's game right now.
All right, Diddy's getting back the stage. But
great stage control from Marlow too, just standing his ground, putting out tilts, spacing them really well.
There you go, Forto.
Marlow looking for the finish.
Well, I tried to go for a stage spike, but fails. Ooh.
Really, really close to dying there, but good DI. Oh no! He went for the forward smash, almost got punished for it.
Okay, another edge guard situation. Oh! Let's not make it.
Oh! Diddy's recovery. A lot of lesser players would have just killed themselves there and not found the way back to the stage.
All right, good DI.
Oh! He was so close to getting edge guarded, found his way back to the stage, got the up smash, and takes game two. That was a nail biter.
Let's see if Marcelo can keep his momentum, even though through that terrible, or that crazy close match.
Yeah, yeah. And that was a. Hold on. These guys playing the neutral right now. Whenever you see someone, a character, run past another character, or you see them like kind of overextend, that's them trying to read each other's movement, you know? Because in the very beginning of playing Smash, you always just hit where the person is. But then when you get really good at the game, you have to start predicting where they're going to be. And that's how you find the hits against top-level players. Uh-oh.
Oh!
Was that a tech, or you just had low percent?
He teched it. For once, he teched it. All right. Is this a hoo-ha? A beep.
Oh, wow. Waited just a split second to try and get an air dodge.
Okay, a good down smash by... Oh, okay.
So, Rob, off stage. Marlow looking for the gimp.
Marlow needs to recognize when to go in and not go in, because at that moment, he got nared. Okay, using the two tools.
Uh-oh.
Forward smash.
Kind of a random place to get caught with a forward smash there. I think what happened was Marcelo whiffed the jab one way, Marlow tried to punish, and then he just got forward smash.
Oh, again.
No attack. And that one was one of the more obvious techs. Maybe the fact that he was further from the stage, you have to time it a little more.
Yeah. Some people get the timing really off.
Yeah. It's sort of easy when you're near the stage, because you just tech right when you get hit. But when you get hit really far and then you get into the stage, you have to have the fortitude to wait that split second.
Yeah.
Uh-oh, can you make it back to this? Oh.
So, I think that was Marlow's jump card, if anything.
Yeah. That's a pretty great option to have. I mean, there's no way to really punish that if you read it, because they either commit all the way to one side or they don't.
Then again, you have to be aware of that in order to punish it.
Yeah.
Okay. Rob taking center stage right now.
And this is sort of a big stock for Marcelo, because if he wins this, he puts all the pressure on Marlow like to have to win or else the tournament's over. Oh, yeah. Come on, I need to get up there. Okay, gets him off stage.
Oh, Marlow. What is this? A missed input?
Marlow has no jump.
Oh.
I don't know what happened there, but he got knocked off stage, tried to up B at a really weird horizontal angle, and that was all she wrote. He kind of flew into the stage, not really out of a mistake, but more just Marcelo was pressuring him, and it's hard to pull off certain things when the other guy is putting all the pressure on you, you know?
Yeah, basically, Marlo choked.
Yeah, Lob, I tried to make it sound a lot nicer, but Marlo choked. Very. It's 2-1 Marcelo, not 2-1 Marlo.
Alright, so we're going to Castle Siege right now. Again, a wonky stage.
I feel like Marlo knows he's getting beat on the honest stages, so he's putting it on a wonky stage.
To throw off Cello's game.
Just because you know there's some of those guaranteed moments where it's going to be wonky and I'm going to get another reset at neutral, you know?
He's probably going for the cheese and possibly back throw him in the walk-off in the next transformation.
Uh-oh.
Oh.
And you know what? In less than 30 seconds, Rob already at over 100%. The stage pick really working out for Marlo right now.
All right. Very dangerous area here. Oh, all right. Got saved by the gyro.
And Marcelo right now also trying to get rid of the statue because it's messing with his projectile game. Oh, I feel like I feel like Rob's throws have really great knockback. So these walk-offs could be really good for him as well.
Okay, any throw really near the walk-off could kill Cello at this point.
Both these guys really try to play the center. They're both scared of the walk-off.
Okay, they're just waiting for the transformation. Good play.
Back to a pretty neutral stage. Oh! Early up B on Marcelo's part because they just totally limited all his options really far out from the stage. Oh, good stage control from Marlo. Good positioning to just stay in front of him the whole time.
This could be... Oh, nice jab reset.
Oh, he baited the air dodge, but didn't do anything with it.
The transformation should be coming up soon. So...
Ooh. Okay, back to the castle. Anything on the top, because the top just stays there and punishes them when they get on. So it's just another thing for the player to worry about. Oh! Marlo with 150%!
Oh, nice wall jump. Okay. Cello's on the ropes right now. Marlo's trying to finish his stock.
Yeah. Marlo has a whole other stock to play with, but again, you can never tell. He SD'd the last game. There's Gibbs. Cello's always in it till he's in it. Great weight on that roll. Transformation. And now we got the walk-offs again, so a throw into the side could kill as well. Look at Cello. Cello trying to bait the walk-off right now. He really wants it. Oh!
Wait, no. He's still good. A little scared, but we're fine.
Oh my god, Cello kind of making a comeback right now. 60% on Marlo. Marlo's shield going down as well. Final game of the first set, 2-2. And now, if Marcelo wins, we got a whole new set, a whole new ball game. If Marcelo wins, I'm sorry, the tournament is over, and he is crowned champion of Otaku Recon. And if Marlo wins, we reset the whole set and do another best of five.
Personally, I would like Cello to win since he's always in his brother's shadow, just like similar to Luigi in a sort of way.
Yeah, I also would like to see Marcelo win. I love Marcelo because you always see him at the top. You know, like you will fall off, Adrian or Marlo will fall off, Brian will fall off, but Marcelo is like the most consistent. You know, he doesn't have the most tournament wins, but I always see him up there. Versus the guys who do win sometimes play poorly some tournaments.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah. For me, for example, I really flunked, but
yeah,
it's okay.
Marcelo is the most consistent, I think, out of all the top players.
Oh.
And you know, as we were talking about Marcelo, he tacked on 93%.
Yeah, right now Marlo is really getting.
Oh, this is bad.
Wait, no, it's fine.
And now he can get Gimp perhaps.
Oh. He went too deep for that.
He went really deep. He went super deep.
So this could possibly be Marlo's last stock, but then we will see.
That's kind of Marlo's trait as a player. He has these really hype moments where you see him get things that you just didn't know were there. But at the same time, he does tend to overextend a lot, you know?
Yeah. He tries to go way too much for the hype.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. This could be... Oh! Okay, so Edge Guard in the cat...
Honestly, we can slow down that moment and talk about it for a solid like 2-3 minutes. There were so many mind games that happened in that little scenario.
Right now, oh my lord.
Oh! So basically what happened was, at the very top of the stage, Marlo side B to get some space, right? And he was going to drift towards the edge to recover. But he just missed the edge. He just choked really, really, really hard.